In this video, I'm gonna show you how to create your asset libraries in Blender so you can easily add models, materials, HDRIs, and even node groups to your scenes. The first step in creating an asset library is to tell Blender which elements will be assets. To mark an element of your scene as an asset, you can use the outliner. Just right-click on the element and choose Mark as Asset. When an element is an asset, a book icon appears in front of its name. You can do this with every element that appears here in the outliner, like models, lights, cameras, collections, or any other thing. And of course, you can select everything in your scene, then mark all of the elements as assets at once. To mark a material as an asset, select the object that has your material, go to the Material Properties tab, right-click on the material, and choose Mark as Asset. You also have this option if you click on the material icon, the shield icon, or again on the material icon in the shader editor view. To do it with an HDRI, go to the shading tab, choose the rendered view so you can see the selected HDRI. Now go to the world properties tab, and under surface, in the color input, click here on this yellow circle and choose environment texture. Now click on the Open button and locate your HDRI file in the file browser. Right-click on this shield icon or on this world icon, then choose Mark as Asset. I recommend that you change this name so it'll be easier for you to identify this asset later. And you can click here on this X button if you want to add more HDRIs to the same blend file. As you can see, the one that I've just configured is still here, so we're not going to lose it. And now we can create a new world data to assign to another HDRI. This way you can add as many HDRIs as you want to this blend file. Now let's mark a node group as an asset. So here I have these columns that I use to visualize what each node group does. And naturally, each of them has its own material. You can use any object you want. I use this column because it's not too complex to make, but it has enough complexity to visualize what my node group does. Okay, so to mark the node group as an asset, select the object of the node group, go to the shader editor view, and in the node group, just right-click on this shield icon or on this material icon and choose Mark as Asset. As you can see, I like to keep all assets of a certain type in one single blend file, so it's easier to find them and make adjustments whenever I want. Now we need to save this project file in our asset folder. So I'm gonna press Ctrl S to save. I already have some folders where I keep my assets, and each of them represents a different library. So I'll save this file in the masks folder. Okay, now it's time to actually create the asset libraries. So I'm gonna go to Edit, Preferences, then File Paths. Blender already comes with a library created. You can keep, rename, or delete it. It's totally up to you. But if you keep it, you need to make sure that the path is correct. So you can click here to locate the folder where you keep your assets. So I'm gonna choose this one. Now I'll click on this plus button to add another asset library. And I'm gonna choose the materials folder. And now I have an asset library exclusively for my materials. You can add as many asset libraries as you want, and organize them however you like. But be aware that if you don't have the autosave preferences enabled, you need to click here to save the changes that you make. Now I'll switch this view to the asset browser. So I'll click on this drop-down and choose Asset Browser. Or you can press Shift F1 multiple times to alternate between the file and the asset browser. So here in this drop-down, you can choose the library you want to explore. I'm gonna select the materials, for example, and now we have access to all the materials of this asset library. So now let me select the masks library. And here you can see that the assets have this pencil icon. This means that these items are editable. And they're editable because they're in the current file. So if you press N, you'll get this panel here and you'll be able to insert information about the selected asset. Here you can choose a thumbnail for the asset, so it's easier to identify it in the asset library. For some types of assets, Blender automatically creates the thumbnail, but for the node group, for example, you need to create it yourself. And you can also add tags to make it easier to find the asset later using the search field. You can also organize your asset library using catalogs. Just click on this plus button to create one, rename it, and then drag the assets you want into the catalog. But keep in mind, you can only drag editable assets into a catalog, meaning the ones that are in the current file. Now let's drag the assets to our scene. So to drag a 3D model, for example, you just need to grab the asset and drop it into your scene. Now let's drag an HDRI to our scene. And the cool thing is that when you drag an object to your scene, it will snap to the objects that are already in your scene. A material you need to drop on a model. In the node group, you can drag it into the editor view. I tried to cover all features of the asset library that I think are important without making this video too long. But if you have any questions, just let me know in the comments and I'll try to help you out. Don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching and see you next video.